Hello and welcome to TAIC. I am Mohammed Adnan. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to create the first flow in Power Automate desktop. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed it, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. First of all, you have to download and install the Power Automate desktop. I have given the clear instruction in my previous video. And then you have to log in to this Power Automate desktop. Without login, you can't able to start the Power Automate desktop. Because in Power Automate desktop, if you are using your personal account, like I have used here, if you are going to use the personal account, then the flows is going to store on your OneDrive, which is not visible here. But if you are using for your official account or school account, then it's going to store on your database environment. So how to create a Dataverse and what it's all about, I have made a separate video on that. Just go and check out that video as well in order to get clear picture of it, how it, you can use the Power Automate and Power Apps. So let's create the first flow. So this is the home screen. You can click on new flow and you can give it a name. Right now I'm going to use the first thing here is how you can able to open an Excel file using the Power Automate. So open blank Excel file. So click on create. Even though this looks very basic, but still I want to go like this because to get clear understanding of how it is and what it is. It will open up a new window for Automate Desktop. Here is the open blank Excel file. And on the left side, you have the actions, this is a canvas, and right side, you have the variables. And now for the easiest way is I can use the desktop recorder. So clicking on the desktop recorder, it has opened up another window here. So I'm going to click on start recording. So if I click here, and then I'm going to go to my desktop. So clicking on this one, start, and in the search, I'm going to type Excel. And here I'm going to click on this icon. It brings up me an Excel file. So I'm going to stop that now. This is a flow. If we go at the bottom, I can click on finish. So let me close this Excel file. So once you click on finish, in that it has given all the stuff, whatever we have done so far. And you can add or remove steps if you want here. The first step here, set window state. I don't need anything here, so I can click on this three dot icon and then click on delete. Even I don't want to wait this as well 2 seconds, and send keys, this or else even I don't know here. Click on UI element in Windows. That's also not required. This is the first thing. Press the button, start button. So this is the one, and then click the UI element window search box, and then wait for 2 seconds is also not required. As I have done slowly, so it has taken 2 seconds for that, but I don't want to take any additional seconds. So I'm going to delete this one as well. And then send keys. So I'm typing it Excel, and then click on the group window and a new blank will opens up here. So now let me save this flow. It is saved here, and if I click on run, even though the Excel is not open up here, if I click on run, it will go step by step here. So I have taken my hand from my mouse, so it is doing by itself by Power Automate, sort and Excel, and it's opening the Excel file. Awesome, right? It has done by Power Apps itself. The flow runs and then it stops here. I can see the blank Excel file here. It's a similar kind of macros if you are aware of Excel things, like what we do in macros in Excel. It's a similar kind here, but it's much far ahead of it. Not only that, you can also do multiple another things as well. Like this one, I'm going to change my next desktop background. Click on new. Change the desktop background and click on create. and click on desktop recorder. It opens up this window, click on start recording, and then click on the desktop. The red indicates that it is on that location. So right click over there and then next desktop background. It changes, right? So I'm clicking on finish now. So click on the UI element, click on the desktop icon, click on the desktop icon, and then select menu here. So I'm going to save this and run this flow. Just minimizing this, I'm now run this flow. Minimize the desktop, right clicking it automatically, and then click on next desktop background. The background changes. So cool, right? So this is how you can able to use the desktop recorder in Power Automate Desktop. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. And also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you're not yet a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.